Hello friends, I hope you all are safe at your home. I finally reached to my hometown and still in quarantine. I am requesting all of you, please stay at your home and stay safe. So today our topic is P50 and P90 estimation. That means the energy management tab in PVsyst software. So please watch the video till the end. I hope you'll get some valuable information from this video. So before wasting any time, let's get started. Hello friends, welcome to my channel all about solar sun, the soul of all energy. Today I'm going to talk about P50, P75 or P90 estimation in PVsyst software. Now, what is the meaning of these terminologies? As I already discussed, PVsyst is a software that can give you the probable generation for any solar power plant. Means the generation probability as per the meteorological data available to the software database. So if you give some irradiance data or weather data or wind data to the software, according to that meteorological data, PVsyst will run the simulation and give you a generation probability for a particular plant according to the inverter and module what you have chosen to the software or what are the data you given to the software. Here P50 signifies the generation probability as 50%, which means when the software run the probability distribution 50 times, the generation exceeded that P50 value. In this case, what you can see, the P50 value what software gives us is 70.306 megawatt hour, which means 50 times the generation exceeded from this 70.306 megawatt hour. In the same way, when you talk about P75 or P90, which means P90 means the 90% probability. Now, here in this energy management tab, the first sub tab is the inverter temperature. There are three options is available. So according to your inverter placement, you can mention your inverter temperature. If your inverter placed in outdoor location, then you can choose the outdoor option. And otherwise, if you maintain certain temperature, you can mention it there. Now, next point is the power factor. Generally, when we use the on-grid inverter, on-grid solar inverter having unity power factor, so there is no need to change the power factor. And the third one is the power limitation. Now, this power limitation basically require where you need to just provide any kind of capping of the power. That means in India, the capping of the net metering system is 1 megawatt. Like beyond 1 megawatt plant, you can't inject any power to the grid. So that's why what you can do, let's say you have a 1200 kilowatt DC plant, that means 1.2 megawatt DC plant, and you provide the 1 megawatt AC, that means the 1 megawatt inverter. As you have done 20% overloading, so your plant can exit 1 megawatt power. In that case, to restrict that extra power injection to the grid, you can restrict that power or you can mention that power limitation in this tab. Now the next tab here, what are the thing I need to choose? I will mention that. So here for the different kind of value, P50, P90 or P75 value, you need to mention some details here. First thing, the kind of data, like which kind of data you need to use here. So here what I generally prefer, which is the monthly average values. Now the climate change percentage, it's totally dependent upon the weather situation and all those values. So there is no as such default value, but you can take the value from 0.5 to 1%. So let's say I am taking it here as 0.5%. Now
take the annual variability from the default value itself. It's 2.5, it's sometimes maybe 5%. It depends upon the project capacity and which location you are working on. And the next parameters are simulation and parameter uncertainties. So these values are the default value. So always try to consider the values as default. No need to change anything here. So I am also not changing anything here. Now here, if you want the P75 value, here you can see P50, P90 and P95 values are there, right? Now I am going to mention here as P75 value. So if you just mention the P75 here, you will get the P75 value as well in the curve and as well as on the report. Okay, this is the P75 value. So in the same way, you can get the report. Now, if you haven't run the simulation, in this case, you can see I haven't run the simulation. So in this case, the PVsyst will ask you, please run the simulation first. When you run the simulation, you can see the curve. So now this is basically the probability curve. Here it's mentioned as E-grid system production. That means your generation according to the probability percentage. Let's say if your percentage is P90, so that means P90 is the minimum generation, P75 is the middle one, and the P50 will be the highest value. And another thing, these curves are coming according to the probability distribution procedure, what PVsyst have the default rule of Gaussian distribution. Gaussian distribution is a statistical process for probability.
Now, if you ask me that when to choose P75 or P90 or P50, how can I decide that which value I need to consider? So for this consideration, first of all, you need to know which type of project you are working on. According to the capital, there are two types of project. One is CapEx project, that means capital expenditure, and another one is OpEx project, operational expenditure. That means you are putting a plant in someone's premises and you are selling that energy to that particular client. So in this kind of OpEx cases, the generation is very important, because according to the generation, you will get your money, right? So that's why during the OpEx project, we can consider the P75 value. Now, why to choose the P75? Because P50 value is the highest value. If you compare these three values, these are the three standard probability percentage what we generally consider: P50, P75 and P90, where P50 having the highest value and P75 it's in the middle condition, and P90 is the minimum value. That means we can't consider the P50, because P50 is the data what software giving you, right? But there are some uncertainty in the data. When we consider the meteorological data, meteorological having different kind of models, and these data are generally 10, 12 years old. So that's why we can't consider these data are accurate. So this is the first thing. Second thing is, as these data are too old, so due to the year-to-year weather change or climate change, the uncertainty comes up. So that's why there is another variability comes into the picture, annual variability. And the last one is the what are the losses you have considered during the detail losses tab. These losses all are the assumption. Practically, when the plant is in operation, the value can differ. So that's why these uncertainty points are very important when we consider the generation. That's why we try to consider that much of generation which I can provide to the client. So that is the main purpose, that if you have some probability percentage or if you have some probability data, so you can differ that which amount of energy I can commit to the client, that this much of energy will definitely you can get from this plant. So for that purpose, as OPEX is a very much dependent upon the generation, so that's why for the OPEX purposes you can consider P75. For the general cases, like for CAPEX projects, when I commit to any client about the generation, I always consider the P75 value. It can vary according to the market trend and according to the competition where you are doing your projects. So it depends upon the situation where you are working on. P90 is basically not recommendable because of that lowest generation. P90 will give you the lowest generation estimation. So we always try to consider the middle one, which I can commit or which I can fulfill. So that is the main purpose of this generation estimation or generation probability. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you are new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button for more tutorial of solar power plant, and please support me and share my videos with your friends, and please hit the like button if you think this video is helpful for you. That's all about today's one. I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thank you.